Yeah, never speak of it again.
Thank you. Desi, you leave the score 7-5. I don't know how to put it 2-2 or what.
First game, sir?
Yes, the first game. Just broke pride right now.
I don't know much about either one of these guys. Where are they from?
To be honest with you, I don't know. They show up. Wiley, he played a lot of tour stuff. But this guy, and
I think he's from here.
But I never see him over here. I know he's top 7. He's supposed to be probably.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's pretty good. But I don't know, you know, so far I see it. You know, but we got to see it, you know. Maybe he's have a good tournament, but I don't know. I think he got the shot to make it, right? But they miss it, you know.
Oh, yeah, he was definitely.
Hey, how are you, my man?
Thank you. Hey, how you doing?
Come check it out, man.
That's good.
He's great.
Yeah, he make mistake.
I can't tell if the one goes by the two.
I don't think so. I don't think so. He tried to. He can go in the side pocket. I think he got the whole ball. To go inside, pocket.
Hello, como está?
Hi, how are you?
I went into the
tour. Yeah, he can make this side pocket. Yeah. He's worried about the three problem.
Yeah, he's got a little work to do still on this out. He's probably shoot the 3-5 combo. What do you think?
No, not really.
With
if you
angle?
Can throw the ball to clear the right in the corner. Where he is almost, you know, in that corner. Because he got the perfect angle to do that, you know. That's what he's going to do. I don't think he go for the combination. Well, he threw, you know. Now you have to hit it real, real soft. That way the three don't.
Yeah, you don't want the three to kick off somewhere.
Exactly.
And get the tough shot.
Yeah. That's going to happen, I think. Ah, he hit it real soft, but you see what happened?
Yeah, the three kicked off.
The three moved to the side, you know. It's not, that's why I don't like it doing that. Even
right.
If he hit it real soft, it's still, you know, the ball moved. Now he's in trouble. You know, he has to bank it.
Yeah.
Geez, lucky he didn't scratch.
Yeah, he hit the outside corner right there.
Yeah.
Got away with that miss.
Yeah, not really.
He's got a back cut in the side pocket with the 6.
No, well, he got big pockets. Even if he hit the 6, they still make it.
Right.
The only thing you have to do is control the white ball to make position exactly like that. See, he still hit the 6 and they still make it. But now he make it more difficult.
Made the 6 a little tough.
Yeah.
Especially the 6 to get back to the 7.
Exactly.
From where he's at right now, too. Yeah.
You have to hit it hard and go to the to go to that pocket where he is right now. That pocket right there.
All right.
Yeah. Now he go for the. He can make the tiri. You know? I think that.
I don't know. Now this guy beat Corey yesterday, right?
Yes.
Yes.
He's a good. I just beat him, you know, but it's not. It's not easy. He played tough.
Oh, he hit it good.
Yeah. Looked like he was the tee to hit the cue ball, but no, it was clear. Or he could make a great shot. I don't know.
Line there.
Yes, overrun the whole thing over there. I don't think the 8 will go past the 9.
No, go past the 9. He's got to shoot it opposite corner on the 10 by the 10.
Oh, I think he go in the side pocket probably.
Think so?
Yeah.
It's a big cut.
Yes, it's a big cut. But
oh, cut it in the, you're talking about the left-hand side pocket.
Yes, exactly.
Okay, and then 2 rails back to the cue ball?
Yeah.
Maybe back to the 9 ball?
Yeah, you go in the middle of the cue ball.
Right.
Middle of the table, you know. But it's not easy either way, you know. Well, the easy shot.
He called it in the corner.
Yep. No, in the corner.
That's why I say he called it by the 10.
Yes. You go to your comment?
Yeah,
okay. No, I got money to do that. What do you want for me? Anything.
We got to eat breakfast. Oh, dinner from last night.
Yeah, it's true.
Vanessa stepping out of the booth to go get some food, and Oscar's going to join me right now.
What's up, Dave? What's up, James?
What's up, Oscar? Tough match we just had.
Yeah, they played like a donkey.
I honestly think you got a bad roll. You made a great move on that 2 ball to come through 2 rails back down to the 3, and it stuck you right on top of the 6. Not only on top of the 6, but dead straight in.
So brutal.
You hit that 2 ball as clean as you could hit it, and it just... I think if you get under that 3 ball like you intended to, that set was yours. It was over. This kid, Racken, right now, he's from here, right? This area? Bay Area?
No, he's actually from Portland.
Oh, is he? Big break, almost scratching the corner pocket, but he's got a shot. Looks like 1-6 combo.
Can't really see it. Oh, there we go. Chris is so tall. Lanky. This kid should have been a basketball player.
See you guys.
Get out of here. Drive safe back.
Thanks.
The six looked like you got a bad bump off the six, but you kind of double kissed the six.
Yeah, tough shot.
Yeah, he definitely doesn't have a cut shot at this.
No real productive safety either.
No, the only thing you do is just kind of slow roll line of nine. And just...
Who won the first game?
Oh, I forgot.
It's okay. Just click on.
A nice call there, James. Hit it exactly the way you said. Very, very productive shot.
Yeah, it's pretty much all he had.
Yeah, nice hit.
Oh, good hit.
And he made it. And the incoming player has the option.
I don't know, do you shoot this? I mean, it's got... really, no pocket. It's got a tough cut on the side, but...
Yeah, I shoot it. I play a safety.
Play a safety, though, right?
Yeah.
Just kinda...
I'd rather have control than my give it back to my opponent.
Now, since you brought up the safety, what would we be talking about safety-wise where?
I like to bank it straight up and down and follow the cue ball behind the 7.
Gotcha.
And make sure you secure this 2-ball on the short row. Oh no, not that.
What in the world? Trying to get behind the 9 there.
What a creative shot. Very, very
to get behind the 9 there.
Very risky. To it.
Wow. Now, do you just try to bump this and get it behind the group of balls and send the cue ball up by the 7 ball somewhere?
I actually put the cue ball on the short route and do the reverse.
You do the reverse?
Yeah. I like to put the object ball like in no man's land, right in the middle of the table. It's very hard to judge a kick. On the cushion's a lot easier to judge a kick.
Gotcha. Like this here, you can just easily spin kick this too. Maybe even hold it.
Actually, I think you might go one rail directly behind it.
That's why I said one rail behind the
two.
Oh,
yeah, yeah. I thought you meant two rails.
No. Just one rail behind the two. Just kind of stick it.
Yeah, that's the shot. And that he's going to hit it, just like you said. Oh, too deep. Got in too much. You know, with this Wi-Fi being so weak, it sucks not being able to know the score of the other tables.
Oh, I know.
We're so spoiled. We're like, hell, we're live scoring.
I've had to get up and look at Melissa's score, look at Collins. Collins up 4-1 right now on Larry Bond.
Melissa's doing pretty good, I think.
And, she was up 4-3 last time I looked. I haven't looked in a while, though.
She's got the 10 ball strip hanging in the hole, so she's... Whatever the case, she's one ball away from winning another game. Nice shot by Mr. Byers. He came out here with Cole Gibbons.
Oh, okay.
So, real happy that they made the trip.
Cole's from that area too?
Yeah, Cole's from Portland.
Wow.
He's been going to all the stops from Portland,
yes,
Oregon.
He has. Wow, that's pretty strong.
That is amazing, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, that's a ton of heart.
Yeah.
Got a little straighter in on that 5-ball than I think you wanted, but you just kind of punched this and floated past the 10, right?
Yeah, I think that's the shot. Oh, no, not that. Well...
9-ball's on the same, a good side of the table.
Yeah.
So it kind of just has to make this ball without doing nothing real goofy.
I would have, That's what happens.
Leaned into it.
Yeah, he leaned into it. It's one of those things where he took what the table gave him, but I'm pretty sure he could have generated, at least, you know, draw it with low outside, and it kills off that first rail. You know what I mean? Just to get at least, you know, a foot closer. But what do I know? I played horrible. That's okay. Villas is a good player, and I had some good games and some not so good.
You guys had some tremendous safety games. I was talking about it in here. Neither one of you really did break and run out. And when you did make balls on the break, you didn't have a shot at the one. So you guys got just great safety balls.
Yeah, a lot of safety balls.
Great safety balls. On just the one ball. That's always ridiculous. I think it was like six games. You just played safety back and forth on a one ball until eventually someone messed up a safe. Mm-hmm. So we got the 4-2 score here. This is the first name is Dunk. Is it Doug Whaley?
Doug Whaley. Doug yes. Whaley.
Okay. And Chris.
Didn't Chris win the first game? That's a good question. Possibly he did.
No. He did.
Okay. They haven't moved the score yet.
Maybe they didn't.
It's 1-1? It means it's 3-2? What?
They both started out 2, that means it's 3-3. Did Chris win the first game?
I don't know. It's 3-3? Yeah, Chris did win the first game, though.
Well, I got a good break there, but the... four ball trickle in front of the one blocked him from having a clean shot at the one ball. And I mean good break. For winning for the four, this table is wide open. Got Mr. Brian Parks sneaking up on me and behind me here. He utilized all my spidey senses.
Nice real first shot here. I hit it good.
Yeah, he had a great break.
Yeah, he did. Uh-oh. Flirt with danger. See how he hits this ball. Oh, nice shot.
I would have used the rails there.
Yeah,
that's
I would have used.
That's why I would have got out of line anyways. But yeah, I would have used the rail there.
Actually, you shot it correct. If that would have been a correct shot, I feel like that's a correct way to do it as well.
Is use the rail?
Yeah, use the rail.
Yeah.
Because you're coming in the angle.
Right.
Whereas drawing it, you kind of have to...
Create the angle
a little bit. It's not easy. But he was comfortable shooting it that way. And
that
pretty risky here. Very easy to underdraw it. You gotta overdraw it than underdraw it, that's for sure.
Well, yeah, you get on the right side of the table, you've nothing to overdraw. Unless you just got real bad luck and overdraw behind the 10.
Yeah, you hit it weak. You gotta do the cross side now. Do you like to hit a high ball or a draw ball here? Low ball.
I'd probably do high and go to two rails, three maybe behind the 10 ball. Shoot it in the lower right-hand corner.
I use a
like
low
to
ball.
Draw, yeah. I like to draw the bank, huh?
I use a low ball because it's a lot easier to control the direction of the bank. Usually when you use a high ball, your body has a tendency to overcompensate, to spin the ball. Where you hit a low ball, it's like automatic.
It's hitting it high.
I hit it well. Nice shot, Mr. Whaley.
Very good.
Four to three.
Trying to sit in the middle of it, and my leg just locked up. I could not get it to that loose.
I can even carry like a nice chair with me at all times. Seat cushion.
Like two office chairs.
Seriously. Two Tempur-Pedic chairs.
Yeah.
I'll take a nap while commentating.
Exactly. All right, around the room that I can see, I got Colin Mazeka is about to be up. Well, he's up 5-1 right now. And
he's looking good to go up 6-1.
Melissa Hernan is up 6-4 on Janard.
So she's on the hill.
That winner plays Brian Parks.
She's on the hill shooting the 10. Winner, winner. Oh.
They think they're going to 9.
Oh, they're going to 9. They included the spot then.
What'd Doug do here? You got a shot at this one and play safe?
I think he's going to bank and slide Whitey underneath the 5 and bank it between the 6 and 8. Bank the 1 between the 6 and 8.
Kind of a tough safety with all the traffic around there, huh?
Yeah, it's a touchy shot. You're almost like, it's very difficult not to leave a window here. It's going to manipulate the cue ball a little bit. Cue ball was good. And you got him.
Yep. Chris already walked to the table with his jump cue.
Saved the trip.
Yes, he did. He didn't want to look at it.
This is a grind, isn't it? Boy, 116 players. Oh my god, he hit
wow.
It. He hit it hard.
I think he got away with it. Nah, Doug might have the edge of the one ball like this. Who do you play next, do you know?
The winner of... what's her name? I think it's the winner of Colin and Larry.
Is the winner of Colin and Larry? Are we that deep already in the startup?
Yeah, 9 through 12. I'm in 9 through 12 bracket. They're 17 and 24.
Doug put a good move on one ball. I thought he could see it.
It's a hell of a shot he'd made. Low inside.
I don't know if that 3 goes by. Still can't tell.
Yeah, it's tight. I'm sure it goes because he played shape for it. Let's see if he hits it well enough for it to still go. So did you hear the news? I got off the phone with the owner of Pool Sharks. No Las Vegas stop.
What?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
What happened there?
I don't know, I guess something came up. I'll explain to you off the air, but yeah.
Oh, so definitely I'll be going to Mesa then, because that was my dilemma. Couldn't go to Mesa and Las Vegas.
Yeah,
since Las Vegas is off the map.
Well, I mean, I still have 2 weeks and change, 3 weeks, basically. I technically can.
Yeah, I hate when they do that to us, because you make the plans, then you change the plans, and then you make the plans again.
Yeah, here's the thing. I'm fed up with that, really. You know, these are clients of mine, and I take their word for it. And
right.
I can't really be an ass about it, because this is... I fix pool tables for a living. That's my main thing.
That's my main business.
But what I'm going to have to start doing is just signing contracts that if they make a cancellation, charge a fee, and that fee goes to, like, added money for the Top Gun or something.
That would be great. Because, like I said, it's not just me. I mean, you guys too, but yeah, everybody.
Yeah, it's
We plan for Vegas, and then it changes, and then, like myself, where I was trying to make a decision, now I'm going to change it and make all the reservations in Mesa.
Yeah.
And then all of a sudden, here comes Vegas again. And
it's really frustrating. Yeah, so Desiree and I are going to... We're going to have a long drive home and really start analyzing what we got to do to A, not let it happen again, and B, find an alternative or just take it off the calendar completely.
Well, no, I like your idea. It's a business. Have a contract.
Yeah.
It's a business. All businesses, when you make a business deal, you have a contract.
Yeah. And it's not only for it's not like my friend Watches told me. He told me, Oscar, you got to have contracts. Desiree told me, you got to have contracts. But I keep saying these guys are friends of mine. I've known them for all my life since I was a kid,
It's not their fault.
It's not everybody's fault.
Yeah, it was out of their control.
You never want to cancel an event.
Yeah.
So if it's being canceled, it's definitely for legit reason.
Yeah, it was definitely...
Definitely something important to them.
Yeah. So
but again, it's still a business.
Uh-oh. Oh, yeah, Doug really... Got up on that ball.
Yeah, you
quick.
Look like me on that shot earlier today, jumping up like Jack in a Box.
You're going to be up on table 3 in a few minutes?
Yeah, I'm ready now if you want.
Well, I'm giving you just got done a marathon, so I'm just going to be with you.
Who?
Divich.
Oh, Divich. Oh. I played Divich.
He's got a spoon. And then, what's actually?
Oscar stepped out of the booth for a moment, so hang tight, ladies and gentlemen. Boy, Doug had a good break there, and table's pretty wide open here. Getting to the two ball, it's probably key to this out. Thank you. Just been joined by the 13-year-old phenom young gun straight shooting, Spencer. Can you say your last name? Landon?
Ladin.
Ladin, like Aladdin, but like, no A?
Yeah, exactly.
Oh, great. It's also his dad's one of the sponsors of the tour at the Aladdin Hyundai in Thousand Oaks. Where
yes.
was that? Thousand Oaks, correct?
Thousand Oaks, yeah.
This guy plays good. He beat Corey.
He beat Corey yesterday.
Yeah.
And Ernesto just said he put up a fight with him. So he had a pretty decent out from the break here. This is from his break. He break really well. Of course, I just put the commentator jinx on him. Got away with the miss.
This kid plays really good. I was warming up with him. He also played in the Junior Internationals about 3 or 4 years ago, I think.
How did he do in that?
I think he came in 7th in the older division.
Oh, nice. He's here with Cole Gibbons and them from Portland.
Yeah, exactly.
There's some love of pool right there, drive all the way from Portland. Me and Brian were complaining about the 4-hour drive here from Bakersfield. This guy's come from Portland. So, Colin Mazeika just made quick work of Larry Bond, beat him 7-1.
Larry Bond beat him?
No, Colin Mazeika won.
The guy beat Chris, right?
What's up?
The guy that...
Yeah.
The guy that'd be Chris. Chris dogs like 3 or 4 nine balls.
I seen the look on Chris's face. He looked disgusted with himself.
I think Melissa's on the hill right now over there.
Wow, what a great kick that was. Sold out, but great kick. Got a bad roll there at the sellout. Melissa's shooting 8 balls dangling in the pocket. 9-10s on the table.
Pretty routine out.
Oh, she almost rattled it, which means she underhit it. Yeah, she got way up table more than she wanted to be on this 9-ball.
Oh, he got lucky. He hit the point there. That was supposed to go way long. That hit the point slow, real slow.
Yeah, he was pretty much all right anywhere on top of the table. I mean, 7 balls in their pocket, so...
Exactly.
It's got a little work to get perfect on this 9 ball.
I'm not sure he maintains the angle on the 7.
He did miss the 9 ball last game. Jason Williams, Vilmos Foldis, Table 2, winner side match. I believe it's to get to the hot seat match, correct? Yeah, because that winner plays the winner of Ernesto and someone else, I think. Oh, Ernesto and that Billy D guy has been shooting really well.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. He's got to get on the 9. He's got a good angle to get underneath it and shoot it by the 10.
Solid shot. Stunned.
That's a good shot right there.
Just a little tricky.
When are you guys heading home?
Soon.
I don't even know what time it is. What time is it?
4 o'clock? 5 o'clock? Wow. 4 o'clock.
Uh-oh.
See, he got tricky there.
I mean, still straight in, but there's a lot of grass in between that 10 ball and that corner pocket up there. Especially on these tight pockets.
A lot of blue sky.
A lot of blue sky, yeah. Yeah, I guess I don't call it green no more, huh? It's blue. He's pretty straight in. I mean, if he just rolls it, he might be okay. If he tries to...
It's that slight off angle. You're
not
sure.
Yeah, it's tough. That pocket up there is...
If you're not sure if you should just hit it with center or just use the right to throw it in. See, he's using the right. He's thrown it.
He made it.
I think he got it. That was a nice shot.
So we got a 5-4 score here. They both started at 2-2, so it's raised to 9. they called Oscar's match on table two. It looks like they're putting them on table three.
Yeah. There we go.
Yeah, he's a little frustrated after his last match with Gomos. Couple bad rolls, couple missed hit balls.
Who do you think should win the entire tournament?
Well, that's a tough call from here. We got Brian Park still in, Vilmos, Oscar, Vesto. Both these guys. Doug's playing great right now. Melissa Herndon will sneak up on you. You are not going to put me on the spot, maybe answer that question right now. I refuse. Good break. Shot on the one. Two balls good. See if he can get in this. One's a little tough, but he's like 6'12", so.
What accuse you playing with?
I don't know. I know I just developed a raging headache all of a sudden, though.
Advil.
I need something. I believe if you're looking for the brackets, they're on www.mezwestatetours.com. That's right. Aspirin. I have a migraine.
Made the one, got nice in the two. Where's the next ball?
It looks like it's the four, so he's got to kind of, I don't know, would you spin this and go into the eight?
Yeah, I spin it and go and try to go behind the eight. Yeah,
that's
like
a good
that,
shot.
Just like that. Behind the eight. Nice angle
from
there.
Two, do you
want
three?
Do you want
three or four?
Yeah, let me have three. Let's really jack my liver up.
There's four. Nice shot right there.
I'm just
going
to
throw
Cinder
there.
Okay.
I'm not sure if he's going to play the 6-9 combo or if he's going to try to short side this ball.
I should just come over and change the camera view. What happened here? How did you get underneath that six ball?
He tried to go around and.
That's a frustration stroke right there. Yeah, that was a frustration stroke. We've all had those.
Mm-hmm. I am not sure. How is he going to get to the seven ball?
I think the seven. Oh, no, seven don't go on the side.
No.
He's kind of straight in. He might just punch this in, draw straight back, take the long shot on the seven. Yeah, let's look like what he's doing. He's just trying to punch it and draw it back, take the
hard cut
on the seven, get back over for the eight.
Or he's going to go on around first.
I don't like the roll first. Kind of leave yourself a bank shot. He banked pretty good, though. He banked a nine ball in earlier.
Well, no, I think you spin it with left. You can come all the way back around the table.
Oh, that's
seven.
Pretty good. That's
natural spin on the way around. I think he's trying to go rail first.
Yeah, he is. Well, I guess you can get a good bump off the knife and hits it really bad.
Look at that. Yeah, see, it seems natural.
Just natural scratch.
That was unlucky.
Yeah, but even so, let's say he doesn't scratch there and he hits that, and it comes two rails. He's more straight in on the seven than he wants to be to punch it back down for the eight. I kind of like drawing back in six and leave yourself the tough cut shot, because to make it, the cue ball has to go back across
the table.
It's natural
down to the eight. I see what you're saying.
Good shot.
Yeah, that's nice. Center table. Right here. Playing the side? Might just overhit it.
Well, he's not making any, taking any time with his decisions where he wants to put these balls. Overcut it. Yeah, this is brutal. This is when you sit in the chair and think about how many games you just gave away and make this 6-4 here in a second. Doug Whaley goes up 6-4, and I believe it's his break.
Scored Jaynard and Melissa?
Nope, but I will in about 2 seconds. It's 8-6. Melissa's on the hill. Melissa Hearn is up 8-6 on Jaynard. Jason Williams and Vilmos is playing on the next table. I'll periodically go back to that camera over there. Jason Williams has his cell phone out. Desiree will take a game away if she catches it with his phone out. It's kind of brutal this late in the tournament to make a mistake like that.
Be this far ahead in the tournament.
Yeah, and make a mistake to cost you a game if not a match because you're on your phone.
I always lose my phone in the car when I play.
I made that mistake yesterday. I pulled my phone out. I forgot all about the rule. I pulled my phone out. I was doing something. And then somebody whispered to me. And I was like, oops. See, what's he got here? A little safety, or you think he's going to try and cut this?
Yeah, he's
I think he's feeling it. He's trying to cut this.
Yeah, he's cutting. He's playing with confidence right now.
Well, and Chris hasn't really put any pressure on him with this couple out of lines.
Oh, no, he's playing safe.
Play safe. Play good safe.
Yeah. I would have cut it and just come down table and put the 2-7 combo.
And that's why you're in the booth with me right now.
Exactly.
Looks like you see the edge of this ball, but I don't know what kind of safe he can get out of it. He did get away with it, but Doug might have a one rail kick at this.
Yeah, it's right by the pocket, too.
Yeah. One rally kind of spins in the right spot to get to the two. He makes it.
I don't know if he's playing safe there or.
It's either or. You hit it good, yeah. It goes in. You get shape on the two, you hit it bad like that, you get safe. It's a good shot either way.
2-1.
Cole Gibbons is out, correct?
Yes.
Yes. It's like the third time this song has been on. Alright, looks like Chris played a little safety here on that one ball and got him, but he can go inside the two with a little spin, the one. Maybe even kick underneath it and leave the cue ball on the table. It's a tough shot though. That's what he's doing. It's so tough to control the spin though off the side rail.
Yeah, I think he's either gonna come really short or he's gonna cut the one ball, leave him safe. Good to go, guys.
That's in the road?
I think I'm gonna eat and I might be back.
Alright. Alright, here we go. Hits it well. Buck-tooth in the booth, huh? I should get buck-tooth in the booth, huh?
I'll find somebody to come with.
Thanks, Brian Barrick at home. Brian is actually waiting on a match right now, and then he plays again. Thank you. All right, 5 or 6 takes some persuading, but I got Cole Gibbons in the booth here.
I wanted to be lazy and not come in, but you convinced me.
It's your road dog.
I know,
booth.
Man.
Why not?
I'm just sitting there sweating the match. I should be in here. I haven't gotten in here in a while. So.
Yeah, you haven't been in all day. Yeah, you weren't in yesterday neither, were you?
No. So yeah, what's the verdict?
We got that 6-4 right now. Yeah, that 10-ball. He came a little understroke, yeah. And then he kind of just kind of rushed.
He did rush it. Yeah. He really rushed it. Yeah, Doug is putting the heat on him, though.
He's playing good, and I'm pretty sure he wasn't really trying to get that roll.
Yeah, we were talking. I'm kind of surprised he's a 7. I mean, he plays strong.
Doug plays really strong.
Yeah.
Beat Corey, but we can't really say that because Corey went on tilt about 6-6. Slamming his cue around and stuff.
Yeah, that'll happen. You got to hold your composure. It's pretty important.
That's a good shot. He almost a great shot if he gets under the 6 instead of above the 6.
Yeah. I mean, he's left him in a kind of a tough situation to get on the 2-ball here.
Yeah, but Doug's kind of free-rolling right now because Chris hasn't really put any heat on him.
Mm-hmm.
But Chris is also in a fortunate spot to be only down
2 games. Yeah, seriously. I mean, Doug's given him 2 3-ball and 2-ball outs,
right,
which is probably doesn't happen often, you know.
What's up? See you guys later out there in the pool world.
Yeah, take it easy, bro.
See ya. This is Mr. Chris Santana, Fast and Loose Designs, hitting the road. Oh, Doug just jot up the 1-ball there.
He dogged it.
Let's see. Chris has to capitalize right here. This is the must-win game.
Yeah, he's got
to
get out here. It's not like the most straightforward. I mean, if he can get on the 2, I feel like he should be golden, you know?
Right.
Everything else is just kind of sitting out in the open.
But he's definitely got to send Doug a statement right now saying, I'm still around. I'm still here.
Yeah. And he's been playing super solid, so I don't see any reason why he shouldn't bear down.
So how long is the drive from Portland?
About 11 hours. It took 13 for us because we kind of, you know, stopped and stuff. But
right.
Yeah, pretty brutal.
Yeah, we were talking about that's some troopers right there.
Yeah.
Portland, Oregon to California to play the Mets. That's a trooper right there.
It's totally worth it, though, you know.
It's awesome.
Where else are you going to get this kind of, you know, good play?
Oh, yeah, it's so brutal. I was just telling my friends at home and stuff, you know. It's great I made it day 2, but once you get to day 2, you start monster after monster after monster. It's day 2.
You've been playing solid, though. Yeah, you've been playing really strong.
Thanks.
Do you, hey, what's up, Dom? How you doing? Who else we got in the chat? Todd Gooch. Shout out to Todd Gooch if you're there, bro. Simona from Classics. I don't know if she's listening. Yeah, this is Cole from Sam's.
All right, it looks like he's got a pretty good position here just to punch it in, draw it off, get to the 10.
Yep, he's out.
Like I said, he's fortunate for the rolls and a couple of bad shots he's played. He's only down 6-5.
Exactly. I mean, the thing about Chris is he kind of gets down on himself a little bit too much. But once he does get focused and get in that zone, it's like it's really hard to beat him. And I know because I've been sparring with him for the past week or so, and it's pretty hard to beat him in a race to 7, at least for me. I mean, Doug's caliber, it's a more even match, but...
Yeah, Doug's been playing strong all weekend. Mm-hmm. Got Melissa Herman 3 doors down, 3 tables down, shooting the 8 on the hill against Jaynard.
Jaynard's got 7, right?
Jaynard's got 7. So, it's a pretty big 8-ball right here. Oscar Gomez on the next 2 tables. Gomez playing Jason Williams up 2-1. Chris got a big break, too.
Big break,
is good. It's a big break in 10-ball.
Yeah, he hasn't been making balls this match, really.
Well, I don't think that's it's at these tables. Me and Jeff Gregg were talking about it earlier. All the guys are big, big power breaks.
Mm-hmm.
They're just, balls are kind of moving so fast because the cloth and the rails are just clacking together and not going in.
Yeah.
You know, the guys with, you know, lesser of a power break, I've been watching two or three balls go in every time because mm-hmm. the balls aren't moving around as fast.
Yeah, the guys that aren't even getting that pop, they kind of just slide it back and it just...
Yeah, they're spreading out. Boy, Oscar just miscued on the 7th. Alright, Melissa looks like she's played a little safety on an 8 ball and actually played a good one. He's got a pinch bank or a safety he's looking at.
Yeah, I say he just drills it in. Janar's a really, like, methodical player, you know? He takes his time.
He plays great.
He never shoots until he's ready.
Doug just missed a whole jump shot by about a whole ball. This Chris's chance, get back into 6-6. 2-3. Actually, look, 6-8. 6-8's a little tough. I guess if you get the right angle on the 5, they just go draw the rail and nip to 6.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the 6 is a good shot to play safe on, you know. Hook him behind that 8 ball.
He's got to get right on this 2 ball though to get anything by that 5 or 6.
I mean, it's not even a bad idea to run into the 4-9, you know. Well, that works better, but.
That's a good shot.
Yeah, that's definitely the shot.
Then you just don't do nothing with the cue ball here. It plays short side on the 3, right?
Exactly. Slow roll it in. Yeah, the 6 ball is the problem ball. Chris is turning 21 on October 15th, I believe. So he's going to be hitting up all the tournaments.
You guys going to Mesa?
Yeah, we're going to try to. I mean, it's kind of close to the Lincoln City tournament, which is like the big tournament in Oregon. It happens every year, but
twice Lincoln a year. City?
Yeah. Yeah, it's like a good amount added. Something like 17,000 added or something.
How much? 17,000?
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah, it's worth the trip, I mean.
Nice to live in Washington.
Oh yeah? Where at?
Up by Port Angeles. It's actually the very tip top of Washington. It's called a little place called Neo Bay, Washington. It's an Indian reservation.
Yeah, I used to live on Whidbey Island in Washington. Short side. No, I don't think you can see it.
How's this one pocket game?
Strong, man.
He might just prospect this in the corner there because it looks like you can see it. Oh shit, he got there.
Yeah, he had the whole ball. I didn't even know. It's hard to see from here.
Oh, I should have changed camera angle. I could have seen it.
Tying this up is huge right now. I think looking at Doug right now in his chair, he's starting to feel a little bit of the heat. He knows he can't be, you know, as loose as he was.
Yeah, this set's going to tighten up real quick. Like, and it looks like Chris is getting a little loose too. So Doug's still playing good. It looks like the rest of this is going to be a gunfight.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Race to 3.
Billis is up 3-1 on Jason Williams. Melissa and Janard are at the same game, 8-7 still. Melissa's shooting the 8, but it looks like she's she played safe, but she just called the bank in the corner, so let's see if she's actually going for it, if she's playing a little safety.
She goes for it.
She went for it.
Man, close.
Missed it. And I think she sold out the eight ball too.
Yep.
Boy, I've just seen Oscar miscue twice in the same game.
Really?
Yes.
I didn't see. Yeah, that's brutal. He doesn't waver much, though. You know, if he makes a mistake, it seems like his memory is pretty short.
Tark's got a big break, too.
Yeah, he does. I like that glove he's using. It looks like it works well. Maybe it's just a regular glove. I don't know.
He's broke dry here.
It's like Chris has
got a good chance to take the lead here.
Place your bets. Yes, please do. So tell me about this James Harris, man.
Oh, my goodness. I don't want to talk about it. Bo and Rod just got completely out of control.
They just don't give
There's just
give
no
it a break.
Control in those guys.
I'm going to have to admit, though, I did Amanda bought the shirts and I wore it, you know. Proudly, I was like,
proudly.
This is my boy James Harris. Gotta represent. Are you bothered by it?
Not at all.
No,
it's all in good fun. I get those guys all the time. I got a little surprise for them coming like a month or so.
That's what I like to hear.
You'll see it. Everyone's gonna see it. It's a great surprise.
Yeah.
So it's always like I tell my friends when I'm talking smack to them about football or baseball, whatever. If I'm going to dish it, I better well take it.
Yeah.
So, and then I dished it. Good shot. As long as it bumps to six.
Perfect.
Yeah. I dished it to them. And they retaliated.
Yeah.
We're just having a good time with it now, so.
Are Bo and Ra at like the amateur qualifiers?
No, they're actually at the Tornado, the Vivian Villarreal's tournament in Texas.
Okay.
They're Barbara Lee and Bo. I think Bo's playing in it, but Ra and Barbara are helping run the tournament and helping Vivian.
Awesome.
That's a big one right there. There's been so many big names that's going to be at that tournament.
Oh, yeah?
That's a big one right there.
Man, I'd love to go, you know, east a bit for some tournaments I've never really been. I know the pool scene out there is huge.
Oh, it's
bigger than
some
here.
People have told me the East Coast has some 5,000 added weekly tournaments.
It's crazy.
It's nuts. That's the second jump shot that he's missed a complete ball
and
sold out
just,
the table.
Yeah, he just bumped the 5 near the pocket and the 4 near the pocket. I mean, this is looking pretty good.
Yeah, this Chris got to like his spot from here. The only actual moving you have to do is 5 to 6,
mm-hmm.
6 to 7. Well, I guess it's all back and forth. 5 to 6, 6 to 7, 7 to 8.
Yeah.
But like you said, he's been playing solid, and I think he's got the first couple misses out of the system now.
Exactly. Played a good shot there, rail first.
Yes.
Kind of like roll forward.
And what do? You just kind of punch this and draw it up table, or you try to move it?
I think he's going to draw back and towards him. No,
yep.
You're right. Yeah.
Got a little bit more underneath it than he wanted, but he's still all right.
Yeah, he can just roll this in and play for the same side corner. Maybe even the side if he really needs to. Roll a little
perfect
more.
Right there.
Yeah.
Not perfect, but just punch it and draw back a little bit.
Yeah. Right out to the rail.
Right by the side pocket. Oh, he hit that good.
He hit that too good. Way too good. He's going to cut this in the corner, though.
Well, yeah, you got to, because you get kind of a two-way. You cut it in the corner, you come back to play shape. If you miss it, maybe get a safety on the 10 or...
hit it good. Hit it real good.
Or you could hit it dead perfect and not worry about missing it.
You're just going to stop this, put a 10 on the side. No reason to do it. Okay, well.
I liked your idea, but he kind of left himself in a bad spot. He's feeling it right now. He might just cut this right in, too.
He's cutting this in.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. He might just cut this right in, too.
Easy. Easy money.
Well, that's a good cut right there.
That was a good out.
Nice and smooth, too.
That was a good out.
Yes, it was. Chris goes up 7-6 after being down 6-3.
Yep, that's a good comeback. He's, you know, this is his first match on the streaming table at this tournament. Kind of maybe in the beginning he was having a little bit of the jitters.
Yeah, it looks like he decided to go ahead and shake those off and play some pool.
Yeah, exactly. That's what you gotta do, man. When you're just so tense in a match, it's just gonna be way harder to stay in it. How do you deal with, like, you know, the mental aspect when you're down in a match?
Oh, you know what? I was down both matches last night, and first part of the match is when I got down, I was beating myself up. And then, like I just said, you know, at one point you got to decide, okay, let's just play pool.
Yeah.
Stop, you know, stop talking to yourself. Stop beating yourself up. Let's just play pool.
Absolutely.
And, I came back both matches.
That's awesome. Yeah, you came back, what was it?
8-3
to go hill-hill.
Yeah, last match of the night, 8-3 to go hill-hill. And then I played a jam-up safety on the five ball and then ran out.
It's beautiful, man. Yeah, there's nothing more satisfying than that. Yeah, I've always thought of myself as like an egalitarian type player where I kind of let, you know, when I'm ahead, I let people come back into the match more than I should. But I've had some good comebacks recently, and it's kind of like, sometimes the roles just go your way and, you know, there's nothing the other player can do about it.
Pushed out to a hook.
Yeah,
I don't think he hands us back, though, because you go two rails underneath the one, you get another safe right back, maybe.
It looks like Melissa finally did get Jane Art, if I'm not mistaken.
Melissa did beat Jane Art?
I'm assuming, yeah.
She did. Melissa Herndon moves on, just beat Jane Art. I believe the score was 9-7.
Probably looking at a safety from Doug here. Just draw back behind the 10-9.
Yeah, they'll go by the 4. I don't see him really trying to aggressively bank this ball. Being down now. Now, if he's up 6-3 like he was, he might try to make this cross corner and hold the cue ball, but you're right with the safety here. Made a good shot.
Yeah,
put the 6
good.
In the way for the jump shot, so Chris has got
good.
To Chris got to actually kick at this instead of jump it.
Hard ball to hit.
Now see, me, I recently, because of Rodney, I like trying to two rail kick under this ball instead of just trying to one rail full.
Mm-hmm.
You got a better chance at hitting the ball going two rails under it.
Yeah, once you get a feel for those two rail kick shots, it's like just so much more comfortable.
Yeah, I used to always try to one rail kick this in the corner, one rail kick this, but no, the two rail kick underneath it, just like that.
Yep.
Just like
and
that.
That's beautiful. Well, he did sell it, but he made a good hit on it.
Yeah.
Go to work.
Go to work. Ernesto going to work.
You know, that's what's so awesome about Ernest, though. He always, I don't know if you noticed it, says, I got to go to work. Yeah. He doesn't say I have to go play. He doesn't say I got a match. So yeah. I got to go to work.
Oh, yeah. He's always, you know, that's some great good business.
That, you know, if you have that mindset, I can never get that mindset to its actual work. You have to go to work. Stop playing.
Yeah. I mean, some people say, hey, if you take it too seriously, you know, you won't enjoy yourself. It's better to just enjoy yourself and remember it's just a game. But at the end of the day, I mean, this is a tournament.
Right.
Trying to win some money.
It is just a game, but did he hook himself?
He just hooked himself.
That's a tough rail first, too. So.
Yeah, it is. I mean, the good thing is if he does hit it rail first, he has a good chance of getting safe behind the 5-6. As long as he aims to hit it thick. Yeah.
Oh, you're talking about the Chinook Winds Open.
Exactly.
Yes, I have flyers and stuff for that. We were actually thinking about going.
You should. Yeah, you definitely should. What do you think? Chris is going to cut this in the corner? Run out?
That's what you think. He's your road dog. You think he's got to hit him to cut it in the corner and run out?
Just based on what you've seen, what would you say?
What I've seen the last three racks, yeah, he cuts us in, goes back and forth, and runs out.
Mm-hmm.
He's definitely calling that shot, too. This is pretty much like just cutting the 10 ball in, actually. Yeah. Just play like it's a 10, and the shape's going to be there.
It's automatic.
Under it.
Yeah, he butchered it, but he hooked him.
He got away with it.
Yeah.
Let's see if we can go over three consecutive missed jumps.
Jump this in the side.
That's tough, though. You got to cut it in the side and play the two rails, but hope you don't scratch in the corner by hitting it.
Mm-hmm. He might even just...
Is he just trying to hit it in the face?
Mm-hmm.
There's no doubt he's aware he's missed the last two jump shots. So
yeah.
I think he's just trying to hit this ball.
Yeah.
Take a little more time on this one than did the last two, though, so...
It's interesting the difference you see between players using the sidearm jump stroke, you know, and then like he was just doing the regular
right
straight stroke.
Well, he just gave this table to Chris again. Cut this ball in between the 8 and the 9-7. Are you just gonna...
I'm not ready. I can help you if you want. I want to stretch your leg.
You want to hop in?
He didn't want to be in here. I made him get in here.
I'm down to just... All right, you guys. Good seeing you guys in the chat. I'm going to go sweat the match from the side. Ernesto's hopping in.
Okay. I think I want to play it, but what's wrong? Not yet.
Well, I'll catch you up here. Chris was down 6-3 and has grinded back in this match with some pretty good safeties, pretty good outs. This is another one he got away with the safety with for a shot.
Yeah.
So this puts him on the hill, 8-6.
He's a good player. Play pretty good this one,
man. He's been playing solid his last couple of rounds. I think he's a little nervous. Cole was saying his first time playing on TV table. So his first couple games, he was
nervous,
a little nervous, and then he kind of relaxed, and he's kind of been getting out from everywhere now. So you're probably playing on a stream next, huh? Huh. You gonna play on the stream next? You gonna play
on
TV?
Know. I don't know. They don't tell me.
Maybe that's why she's making you wait.
I don't know. I went to eat dinner this morning.
Did you?
No.
Is it good?
Yes.
What'd you have?
Vegetables and soup. Vegetable soup.
Oh, and I see Oscar eating right now.
Yeah, I bring him some soup too. You know, even eat yesterday too. Last night.
It's not healthy for you guys.
No, I know, but we are busy all the time over here. What is it? You know.
Alright, Doug's brakes kind of failed him the last couple times. He's broke real well but came up dry. And he did it again, but safety behind us, the 910.
Jason Williams is coming back over there. Hockey plays, you know, you see the cue stick every time, you make this funny song.
Tink, 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 like it's solid rock.
Like it's rock already. Yeah. But he played good that way, you know.
Plays great. What about that noise?
Yeah. Don't bother him. That bothered me like hell right away, you know. Oh. I cannot even stand that.
I asked him many years ago, how do you play with that sound? I don't even hear it anymore. That's what he says to me. I don't even hear it anymore.
Well, he get used to. Mm-hmm.
Chris is kind of pushed into a hook. I don't know if Doug might shoot this though, being down.
I never shoot that one. Why?
Yeah, I mean,
no safety, no nothing. You look at nothing over there. You have to pass that shot. Wow.
He's taking the shot. I don't know why he's taking the shot.
Why? It's a free shot. He's kicking the ball.
Yeah, two rails.
Well, it's okay. You can, something can good can happen from there, but you got a rail? Barely got a rail.
What do you do here? Do you just kind of roll the one forward, put the cue ball on top of the two?
Yes, it's one shot, yeah. That's the easy one, and obvious. I hit it too hard.
Yeah, too hard.
Yeah. I broke and ran
hill. That's good.
That was him. I saw you guys pull a little baseball one game, you tried to back it long run. So he got out there, but it was over at Cleveland.
That's exciting. Put the cue ball behind the tree. Oh, the another way.
It's another way. Yeah,
the another way. It's a shot. Yeah, you got the four balls to hook it, you know? You have to send a cue ball to behind the tree, you know, easy, and bang.
The cue ball right here, and then the one ball all behind over here.
You got a wall to hook it, you know. This way, you can make it, but it's tougher.
It's gonna go one rail up behind the 2-7 up there.
No, you
hit a little fat.
You have to play billiards to do that kind of shots. So. That way you haven't. Good knowledge, and he got that shit. He can make the ball over here and play, made the four with the billiards over there. What is the two? No, right here.
The two is up here by the seven.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, no, two in the middle of the table.
I thought it was the table.
That's a four by the seven.
Yes. Safety.
Good safety. Ooh, I don't like this jump shot. It's too close to the. You gotta land on top of the one almost. And
No, I think the best way to do is land in the rail first, and then kick the tree one from behind. Like that, it's okay, he got away, I think.
Yeah, he did.
There you go. Another air bubble.
Here we go.
Get away? Maybe? No.
No.
No. Well, it's no four. You have to play billiard with the seven.
Yeah, carry him the seven ball.
Yeah, carry
him. And then make sure the four goes to where you can make it. That's six balls down there.
Yeah. It's nice.
It almost goes up 5-3 on Jason Williams. I'm not sure what Oscar's score, and mostly just informed me and Ernesto that her and Jane Aaron's match went hill-hill, and she had to break hill-hill and broke her right out for her win. That's a good shot on that one ball he just made right there.
Yeah, three rounds.
Touching. If you hit it too short, you get hooked by the five. Hit it too long, you don't get the carry on the seven like you want.
Yeah.
What do you do? Just take the shot down here by the corner, make sure you get the carry, or you try to move the cue ball?
I try to stay in the long rail, the closest I can.
Right.
Like right now, you avoid the 8-ball, and you can hit the 5.
Right, that's what I was saying. If you avoid the 8, you get hooked by the 5, you hit the 5.
Yeah.
If you overstroke it, then you don't have to carry them no more. You got to do something else with the 4.
Yeah.
If you stay under the 8, well, he went inside. You see that take his carry away?
No, he still make the carry, right?
He still make the carry.
Oh, yeah. But you have to hit rail now with the inside English. And grab the
but then you also got to make sure where the four is going, so you
well,
get a shot at the four.
The four bounce where is the five ball is right now. Bounce in the middle of the table. If you do the right shot.
Right. I think you might have to go watch it hit, sir.
And I can watch it from here. I can tell them. But I think if he hit the rail first, it's possible he got to hit the seven first. Good shot. Yeah.
Oh, now double shot. Kiss. Got the double kiss
double
for
kiss.
The shot.
Yeah, it's pretty good. He come a little short. Maybe he got to stop the ball right there.
I was going
to
say, he just stopped the ball there, take
yeah,
the quick
well,
shot on the 6.
He cannot get better than that. Or go three rails, avoid all the whole traffic in the middle. Probably is why.
I like your first choice. Just make the 5 and take the cut shot on the 6.
No, you can
oh, go, he's going three rails.
Three rails, you know, you can go three rails. Too soft. Too soft, too soft.
That's why I didn't like the three rails on this cloth. It's still fairly new and it's kind of sliding.
No, he overspin the ball.
Did he overspin?
Oh, yeah. I don't know why. It's supposed to come short. The three balls and it wasn't in Nayo and Kamun in the way.
cut the ball.
Was it, did he overcut it, or was he playing safe?
He played safe, but yeah, he overcut the ball too much, you know.
It's a good save when you're up. What do you do here, Ernesto? Try to spin it in or play safe? Is he frozen?
Yeah, probably. I send the ball to the long rail and try to put it behind this 9 and 10. That's what I do. So that on purpose. You know, and the long rail.
Right.
But bring the cue ball down. Like, where is it right now? See?
Oh, gotcha, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, he got lucky already, I think. Yep, he got away.
So what do you see for safety here? I see Din in the six ball, one, two rails behind the 9-10 maybe?
No, yeah, you hit the real 10 and then with the English and then put it behind the 8, 10 and 9.
Right, but the six within over here, exactly, and yeah, then two rail right here. Exactly. And then, yeah.
That's the only shot you got, probably. Right. The right, the more, for sure you got to hook it because you got three balls to hook it. But I don't know, you know. Everybody thinks different. You know? He go for the 8.
You call the 8?
Yeah.
Brian Parks is playing Melissa Herndon right now.
Very aggressive game. Very aggressive shot.
Oh, he made it. Hit it good.
Yeah.
Just roll this in one rail back to shoot the 9 in the same pocket, right?
Same pocket, exactly. Come short again.
Did you just call the 10 ball?
Yeah.
You just call the 10 ball.
Well, he said I made the 8, why not I can make the 10?
Chris just gave him an opportunity to close out this set.
He wasn't a heel, right? He wasn't a heel, right? They marked the 2 games already or not?
What's that?
They marked the 2 games already or not?
No, they started at 0-0.
Oh, start 0-0?
Yeah, we got this. They started at 0-0.
Oh, okay. Pretty good shot. Perfect speed.
Goodness, did that just happen?
Well, that's what happens when you lose. You miss that kind of shots, you know. You know what happened? He got the bank easy. You know, even go to touch the rail. Boom, right in the middle. Wow. He's jumping all over the place. I love it. Ah. They're still alive. I think he can make it.
It looks like he got it.
He got it.
Hey, he's flying it, folks.
He's flying it. He's flying it.
Almost up 6-4, 6-3 on Jason Williams.
Three, one,
Look at Oscar. Oscar's up 7-6, and I just been informed Melissa Herndon is up 3-1 on Brian going to 9. Wow, I don't know if you guys seen that in the background, but that shot Vilmos just put on Jason Williams was a great shot.
Oh, the safety.
Yes, great shot.
Mm-hmm. No, I said, I don't know if you guys were looking.
James is like, be quiet. Is he completely
snipping? Full
ball. You can make it that shot. Hit the rail first.
No, I was talking about Jason's shot.
Oh.
Hook him, maybe?
Oh, he got lucky. He's not so down, nothing. Oh, yeah, he's so low. Huh. I'm blind. How can I see him?
It's tough for Arnest, though. You're not blind. Straight shooting guy.
It's hard to see the angles from here.
Yeah. Uh oh.
That's all.
Short again?
Too short again. Oh, the 5-ball is the key. But right now he wants to try to break the 4-ball to the 5, you know. I don't think the 5 passes the 9.
It actually looks like the 5 passes the 9.
We look
it's kind of a big gap there.
Okay. He planned to do that, and then supposed to go.
Good shot, but he hit it short again.
He hit the tee. And the tee stopped him. Did the play safe? I don't know.
That's pretty good discipline right there, instead of just trying to cut it in and go all the way around the table.
Try
to go inside and hold it.
He was in perfect shape to do that. It wasn't that tough. But, you know, everybody depends how you feel.
You would have cut it in with inside and hold it up.
Probably, yeah. Because every time you play safe and safe, you give a chance to the opponent to kick the ball to the good and kick it back. Or
kick you safe.
Kick it safe.
Accidental
hook.
Hook
you. Yeah, something can happen.
Boy, Jason almost came out of his clothes on that break just now.
Yeah. Overspin, hit it hard. Too much power. He can kick the ball over there and put the cue ball behind the 7.
Call the 7-ball.
Call the 7-ball. You have to kick the ball first before you even do something else.
Or try to make the ball. You gotta hit the ball.
You have to hit the ball. Guarantee you got to hit the ball. After that, whatever happens. You know? But don't give your ball in hand to the opening. Because
spin it 2 rails by the side pocket. Yep.
It's perfect because that way you can go to the 9. Perfect angle. Crossing the rail, but that's okay because you don't have to force anything. Perfect.
You follow three rails here?
No.
Just draw it?
Draw the ball because draw the, ball right? The cue ball is so small, it's real easy to draw the ball. Real easy.
Good shot.
Yes. You win already, right?
Yep. That's it.
My turn.
Okay. I told you you're going to be outside.